Welcome to an all-new series from Lambda Test on Selenium with C# and MSTest Framework. In this all-new series, we are going to be talking about what MSTest Framework is and how to get started with it. How to write super simple code with MSTest Framework and Selenium. How to write parallel test for Selenium code using MSTest Framework. And finally, we'll be running the same parallel testing code with Lambda testing platform for cross-browser testing and cross-platform, and also running the locally hosted application within Lambda test platform. So this series is a to-the-point series covering all the important topics required for anyone to start using MSTest Framework. Well, as I said, in this video, we'll be talking about MSTest introduction and installation. So what is MSTest Framework? MSTest is the Microsoft test framework for all .NET language. It's extendable and works for both .NET CLI and Visual Studio IDE. Like other test frameworks such as NUnit and XUnit, MSTest also has all the rich test framework functionality which is required for performing testing of our application. It can be an unit test, it can be an UI-based test such as Selenium. It has all the rich functionalities which is required for performing a test operation. And there are many advantages MSTest has. Something like MSTest Framework has the data-driven capability as well as custom attribute capability, which can be helpful for us to write custom attributes as well as running the test via data-driven testing using CSV file, JSON file, or Excel file, or even data sources like SQL Server databases. And MSTest can run the test in both IDE as well as CLI in both parallel and sequence operations. And MSTest is a .NET Core compatible framework, meaning it can run on Windows, Mac, and Linux operating system without any problem. And using MSTest's test context, it's easy to get the current state of test execution and reporting directories and even more functionalities which is required to perform test operation to get the current state of the test, which is used for the reporting purpose mostly. Well, as I said, MSTest has got a super simple structure, very much close to the other testing frameworks such as NUnit and XUnit, something like this. As we can see here, MSTest has got the test class attribute, which is decorated for the class, and has got the test initialize attribute, which is mainly used to initialize the drivers or database or any file systems. And there is the test method attribute, which is used to perform test operation of our code. It can be a Selenium test, it can be an unit test, or it can be an integration test. And then the test cleanup attributes is used to perform the cleanup of driver or database or the file system IO operations once the testing is completed. So this is the basic structure of the MSTest framework, which is pretty close to NUnit and XUnit frameworks. Well, as that said, the setup and prerequisite of the MSTest is quite easy and quite simple because MSTest come along with Visual Studio IDE and it's a default test framework. Hence, installing Visual Studio 2017 or above will have MSTest template by default. And we are going to add Selenium reference within our code so that we can start writing the Selenium code starting our next video. Well, as that said, this is the super simple setup and prerequisite. We'll start creating a simple MSTest project in this video and we'll see how the project is going to look like. So we have Visual Studio 2019 installed within our machine and we're going to start creating the first project of our MSTest. So for doing that, first click this create a new project, which is going to show you all the different project templates available within your Visual Studio. And you can see that the recent project template shows me the MSTest project with .NET Core. But we can also search the MSTest framework from here, which is going to bring us the MSTest project for .NET Core. It is available in C#, VB, and F#, but the one which we are going to be choosing is the C# language binding. So we're going to select this, we're going to hit next, and then we can give a name here, and we're going to hit this create. And since this is a .NET Core compatible project, it is going to have all the dependencies required to run .NET Core based test for Windows, Mac, and Linux operating system. And as we can see here within our Solution Explorer, it's going to resolve the dependencies for us automatically. And it's going to have the Microsoft .NET.Test.SDK, MSTest.TestAdapter, and MSTest.framework. And it automatically discovers the test within our text explorer because that is the nature of MSTest. Something like this. And within our MSTest project, you can see that it will have the unittest1.cs file, which is going to have the test class attribute decorated for the unittest1 class. And it has got a test method for the test method that we are going to be running within our code. So the simple code, if we try to write something like console.writeline, and if we try to run this test, it's going to run the test for us and it's going to show us the output over here. So this test framework, the MSTest framework, is going to look pretty much exactly same like how it works for other testing frameworks. In our next video, we'll see how we can actually start writing the Selenium code to run a browser-based test using MSTest framework.
In case you have any questions or you're requiring further information, you can chat with the team, or you can also drop us an email at support@lambdatest.com. We're here to help and we'd love to hear from you.
Subscribe to our channel to stay on top of exciting features on your way. Happy testing!